Feature Friday.
The freshest.
Alright, so let's. This is a very peculiar one. I've used that word quite a lot today. We're gonna watch some old school stuff. We're gonna watch Selena, or Selena, in English, I guess that's what we'd call her. Como la flor. I'm not talking Selena Gomez here. I'm talking, I guess you could say, the original Selena, to some extent, you know. She, I remember we watched the movie, and I was like, the movie about her life, and I was maybe 7, 8, you know. So I don't know how long ago that was when we watched the movie. Must have been like 15 years ago, maybe more.
And she became my instant idol.
Yeah, because we didn't know who she was. I mean, we were way too young. And when did that song actually release? Como la flor.
Como la flor. Sí.
90s.
Maybe before, porque ella muere en el 94. Right. So, let's see.
Yeah, because I don't know any other songs, to be fair. I know a few, actually. Yeah.
The Stun. She's got such cool songs. I mean.
That released 1992.
Yeah, a while back. October 1992.
Como la flor.
Como una flor, con tanto amor.
Right. So yeah. So and then she passed away. Well, she didn't pass away. Yeah, she was murdered.
Killed.
In
1994.
So. We thought this would be really cool to sort of see the music that shaped some of your music, you know, like she's one of your biggest inspirations.
Well, she was the first person to break that boundary between the American music market and the Latin music.
Right.
She was the first person to make that bridge between the Latino like music industry and the American one.
Yeah.
So everybody that came from South America or Latin America overall and was living in America in USA in the moment back in the 90s, they had their own genre of music that they used to bring from home, but nobody would be interested in listening to it because it wasn't American music.
I see.
Even though we're Americans that had heritage that were making it in the United States, but it didn't have a market until Selena kind of like made a bridge between the two.
Right.
And she was about to release she was working on an English album when she got killed, her first English album.
Damn.
So that would have been absolutely mind blowing. I think some of it, or if I'm not making this up, I think the album got released after.
Really?
Yeah, I think so.
Damn.
Or a few songs of it that were finished, I think. Yeah.
Yeah, I was too young. I was way too young.
Yeah, you weren't even born when the whole situation happened.
Hell no. I was born in 98.
Yeah.
You were born in
95, the year after.
Right, okay, I see.
Yeah.
So we must have watched the documentary or the movie or whatever it was.
Yeah, yeah.
Like 2005, 2006, 2007.
Something like that.
Yeah. It really did mark you. I remember it marked Ballet a lot. It marked you a lot.
It literally shaped my idea of what I wanted to become. She was like, I want to be her. End of it.
Yeah. So we thought it might be fun because, I don't know much of it. So it's basically like I'm doing it for the first time.
I actually think this is your first time watching this. This was her last iconic concert ever. This was the last thing she did, like huge in the public.
Right.
When she sang in the Astrodome.
I see. So this is basically the first time I've ever seen this.
Basically.
So this is my first time. It isn't yours. So we just thought it'd be fun.
Yeah, this is the remastered version. So they uploaded this like 2 years ago again. And I was so excited when this came out.
So the audio is like, better.
Yeah, and right. The whole video is in better quality and everything. So
yeah,
enjoy it.
Yes, what? I know how it goes. Come on, I'll flow.
You just have to see her. It's like the whole experience.
Me gustaría dedicar esta canción a todos ustedes.
She's so
porque
cool.
Ustedes hicieron esta canción un éxito, el primer éxito para nosotros. Aquí en los Estados Unidos, igual como en México.
Look at that outfit, that was the most iconic outfit ever.
She's right, she's been very attractive. She was very
beautiful.
Attractive.
She was beautiful.
Damn!
It's son sus hermanos tocándole los instrumentos.
Wow.
Oh. She's perfect.
Damn, man.
Oh, it gives me goosebumps. She's so perfect. You go, girl. So charismatic.
Did you say perdón?
Pero.
Ah.
Vaya.
Every karaoke now.
Literally.
Damn. Yeah, she was special, man.
She was so special.
Con tacones. It's nostalgic listening to it like this. That's a clean outfit, man. Damn.
She was iconic for all her outfits.
See.
She also
conga,
used, oh yeah. She also used to design her outfits.
Oh really?
So yeah. She had a whole line of clothing, and actually that was the reason why things got nasty for her.
Oh really?
Yeah.
The clothing.
Not the clothing, but the person who was managing her books and all her economic side of the things, like her numbers and everything.
Is it true?
Got, yeah, they she was stealing money from them, I think,
right.
and then I think. Her dad found out that she was stealing money, and that woman got really
riled up,
crazy about it.
Oh, I thought this is what my head is. How this story goes in my head from the little bit I can remember from the documentary. Wasn't it that she, for some reason, wanted to? I think that's whatever you said. That's right. But then she shot her, but she was meant to shoot her in the shoulder or something.
No,
she
got shot in the shoulder, but it hit an artery, and she died.
But the person was the person really meaning to murder?
I don't remember.
Because I remember there was something like that. Like,
I don't think she meant to kill her, but
right.
That's how it went.
She did shoot her.
So. Yeah, that's how it went.
Damn, I don't even know if we can use that language because of YouTube system, but
it's such a terrible, tragic story because she was something so special,
and she was
she became everybody's idol.
Well, no wonder. Jesus.
Like, she was something so her, like,
very sad.
I don't know. Yeah, she really shaped the industry for Latin music coming after.
Yeah, dude, that dress would murder right now.
Oh, believe me,
that's
it
20
has
years
been,
ago.
Yeah, it has. This has been, this look specifically has been like
redone
so many times because it's so iconic. Actually, Kim Kardashian dressed as Selena one Halloween, I think.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh wow, nice.
She looked really good too.
Yeah, I bet.
No in ear monitors, just. Puro cañote.
Old school.
the guitar player at the back with the long hair.
Right. Right.
That was her husband.
Oh, wow.
They got married in secret.
She's great, dude. The bass. Dun, 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 dun. Damn. Down, control. Say, broke the record.
Yeah.
Wow, so I was there closing bit. That is incredible, man. And her legacy carries on to some extent. But even her posture is like...
She was a star.
An idol, dude.
She was a star. Fireworks.
Wild.
Makes me mushy in the middle.
I wonder if anyone watching so far had the privilege to watch her live. Can you imagine?
Oh, could you imagine?
How crazy would that be?
Oh my god.
If you have, let us know what that was like, because that seems insane. See what people are saying in the comments.
Well, the cheese and icon.
Well, did I, is that, hold on, did I see that right? 138 million views.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
138 million views.
Mayo
2020 y seguimos en seguimos viendo esto.
Can't use that word because of YouTube demonetization.
Yeah, we're still watching it. That's for
why
sure.
Are people bashing Kim K and other women? Also, she dressed up.
Yeah.
No les parece como que sus canciones nunca pasan de moda.
Siempre muy frescas. It's true. They're always so fresh. They're always on trend. No
the
matter.
Songs, yeah.
Yeah. No matter when you're listening to her, you're always gonna be feeling a good mood.
Sup people, if you're watching this and you're a rapper or a beat producer,
a singer, a ghostwriter, or even just somebody who likes new music,
then this is for you.
Feature Friday is the show where we make new music every week featuring your tracks, your raps, your lyrics, or yourself as an artist.
There's no catch. This isn't one of those weird posts where you click on the website and you're trying to order AirPods and they say it's free and then you have to pay like $100,000 million for shipping. This is completely free. We understand how difficult it is in the music industry to get seen, and there's so many amazing rappers and singers and beat producers out there. So this is just a place to showcase your skills. We showcase our skills. We make music every week, which we love doing anyways. We get to show new artists to new people and new people to new artists.
So if you'd like to get featured next, message me here on Instagram or email me and we will get in touch pretty soon.
Please do it fast because a waiting list is forming and we don't want anyone waiting around. Keep scrolling by.
See you Friday.
Peace.
Bye-bye.